Hey guys, this is the November mood board for the Take 10 kit, so I hope you guys enjoy it. And if you're not already subscribed to this awesome little kit, there will be links in the description box below. Hey guys, welcome back and thank you so much for joining me for another sneak peek of this awesome little kit. And welcome to my channel! Of course, if you watch my channel, you know that I'm obsessed with stamps, so of course I had to choose the stamp set from this month's kit as my sneak peek, but I kid you not. This kit this month is absolutely adorable, and you're gonna want to get it because it's just amazing. So I went ahead and stamped this ahead of time, of course, so that you guys could kind of get an idea of what it looks like when it's just stamped in black. And I did stamp that in archival ink. And then I created some other banners, which I did ahead of time, where I did some more watercoloring, which you guys know how much I love to do watercolors. And I created all these different colored banners just to show you the versatility. You know, you could create a bunch of these banners and just have them ready to go for your November spreads, or if you're catching up on your October spreads, because they're just that cute. One of the banners I did create, I removed the currently, as you can see, and put in Hello November, which I did that with some white paint and a paintbrush because I just thought it would show you the versatility. You don't have to use the word currently. You can mask the word off and just use the banner shape if you want, or you can use both together because they're both equally as cute. But it just gives you some more options so you can see that, like, the only limit you have with stamp sets is your imagination, really. And I love creating embellishments to have before I start my pages so that I have options. So that's why I decided to create some and show you guys exactly what I did to create them. This I created using one of the banners, and I took out the currently and put Hello November, and I used my watercolors to create that kind of pink gradient. And I punched out a circle and I believe that's a starburst type of circle. I'm not sure if that's exactly the correct term, but those are the two shapes that I used and I layered to create that effect. And then I used the little girl and boy potty people that came with the stamp set, and I thought they were really perfect for this, especially because for, you know, your layouts, if, you know, you're taking a picture with your significant other, it's really easy to use these little potty people to create this cute little effect. So I decided to stamp them in sepia because I previously did them in black, so I just wanted to see how they would look with the sepia, because usually when I think of November, I always think of brown tones, so I decided to go with the brown here. And I thought it was so cute to get these little potty people shapes because I actually don't have any stamps that have this shape, so this will be my first. And if they weren't already so tiny, you could probably also use the shrink-a-dink on these too, but I think they would become way too tiny if you did that. Right now, they're actually the perfect size to have on your project life spreads. And just like you're stamping, you see me stamping them on the circle, you could also go against stamping them directly, and you could stamp them on a piece of white paper, then cut them out and then place them. Because even though they're tiny, they're not so tiny that you can't fussy cut them. So that's just an idea right there. And then I'm stamping the banner, and I did mask off the currently again, just so that I could show you guys on camera exactly how I go about doing it. I honestly just cleaned off the currently right after stamping it so I wouldn't have to even worry about masking it off, and I did that with a baby wipe. And then I decided to make the banner blue, so I pulled out my watercolors again and started working on this. Usually I will tell you that it's easier to stamp it's easier to watercolor first and then stamp the banner because the ink itself will start like fading out the black ink or the sepia ink. You won't see it as much because the watercolors for some reason just fully cover it. So I would say definitely if you're worried about that, just go ahead and do your watercolors first and then stamp. But the reason I didn't do that, even though I knew that was going to happen, was because I just wanted to see exactly where I was putting my gradient with the colors. So that's kind of the conundrum with that. But I ended up just going over the lines again with a black pen, so it really didn't affect it that much, and you can do exactly the same thing, or you can even use some Copic markers or something so that you don't even have to worry about that at all. So that's just an idea for you guys. So this is just the easy part where we're just putting parts together, just gluing down the circle on top of that little like starburst shape. And then I'm just deciding where I'm going to put the banner, if I want to have it offset or right on the middle. Because I don't mind if it covers the potty people a little bit. It all has to do with what your style is. Then I'm taking a Sharpie and I am writing basically a sentiment within the banner, which I'm just putting Hello Fall, just to do something different from the Hello November. And I do recommend that you use a Sharpie when doing this, because certain pens don't work well on top of watercolor. For some reason, it makes them kind of like just stop working correctly. And I have had this happen, so you can trust me on that. And then I decided to stamp the little heart because I felt like the banner needed a little something more to kind of just make it pop. So I decided to stamp that and then just color it in with some watercolors. But first I'm gonna just glue down the banner and figure out exactly where I want it, because it'll make it easier for me to decide where the placement of the heart basically is gonna go. So I thought that little heart just went perfect right there in between the both of them, and I tried to give it like a little subtle ombre effect going from a little bit darker to lighter to the top, so I think it came out really cute. And I'm just using my Tombow Mono Multi just to add a little bit of glue, and there you have it. There's really so many ways you can use this stamp, so I hope you guys won't be limited to what I did, but if you like what I did, feel free to incorporate that sort of version into your own and make your own banners, and you can run them through your Extron machine and even make your own stickers. It's really cute. And then I also went ahead and made a little tag where I just used the family stamp, and then I used a little heart and I stitched it onto there, and I just put it on the Project Life card with some removable adhesive, which is why it moved around a little bit. I just figured I would give you guys one extra example of how to use the stamps. But anyway, I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, enjoyed the examples that I made. Be sure to check out this month's kit. There's going to be links in the description box below. And thank you guys so much for watching, and for all your sweet comments. Bye, you guys.